Hello everyone, I am Monalisha Padhi. I am a legal intern at Lexis & Company. And I am a third year student of BBA LLB and I am pursuing it from Bharati Vidyapeeth New Law College, Pune. And today's topic is, victim of rape habitual to sex is not a ground of defense. In Abdul Sattar v. State of UP, the Supreme Court observed that the fact that victim of rape is habituated to sex cannot be valid defense to the act of rape. Rizwan was accused for raping a minor girl. To allow the bail petition filed by the accused, the Allahabad High Court took note of examination report which stated that the prosecutor sustained no internal or external injury on her person and that she was habitual to sex. In appeal against the High Court order, the bench headed by Chief Justice of India, S.A. Bobde, observed that the High Court has noted the opinion of a doctor that the girl was habituated to sex. This appears to have led the High Court to consider the case of accused sympathetically. We are of the view that the fact that victim of rape is habituated to sex cannot be a valid defense against the act of rape. Immoral character of victim, evidence act and views of Supreme Court. Section 155 of the Indian Evidence Act deals with impeaching credit of witness. Before its amendment in 2002, this provision had a clause 4 which read thus, when a woman is prosecuted for rape or an attempt to ravish, it may be shown that the prosecutrix was of generally immoral character. The Law Commission of India in its 172nd report suggested omitting this clause, opining that there is no relevance or reasonable connection between offence of sexual assault and the general immoral character of the victim. Much before that, the Commission in its 82nd report emphasized the desirability of amending clause 4 in section 155 to make such question permissible only to the extent of her previous sexual relationships with the accused, but otherwise to bar any questions regarding the prosecutrix's general immoral character or previous sexual experience. Later in 2003, these provisions were deleted from the Evidence Act. Even before the said amendment, though not in the context of a rape trial, the Supreme Court had observed thus in State of Maharashtra v. Madhurkar Narayan Mardikar 1991, even a woman of easy virtue is entitled to privacy and no one can invade her privacy as and when he likes. So also it is not open to any and every person to violate her person as and when he wishes. She is entitled to protect her person if there is an attempt to violate it against her wish. She is equally entitled to the protection of law. Interestingly, the constitutional validity of Section 155 Clause 4 of Indian Evidence Act was challenged before the Andhra Pradesh High Court in Golap Krishna Lakanidhi v. Union of India 2003 by raising a contention that even though the character of an accused becomes irrelevant in terms of Section 54 of the Evidence Act, whereas the same is used against the prosecutor in terms of Subsection 4 of Section 155 thereof, referring to some Supreme Court judgments, including Madhurkar Narayan Mardikar, the court held that the Section 155 Clause 4 of the Evidence Act, for all intent and purport, has fell into insignificance and thus it is not necessary to pronounce the said provision as unconstitutional. In State of Punjab v. Gurmeet Singh and others 1996, it was held thus, even if the prosecutrix in a given case has been promiscuous in her sexual behavior earlier, she has a right to refuse to submit herself to sexual intercourse to anyone and everyone because she is not a vulnerable object or prey for being sexually assaulted by anyone and everyone. In State of UP v. Pappu at Yunus AIA 2005, this court held that even in a case where it is shown that the girl is a girl of easy virtue or a girl habituated to sexual intercourse, it may not be ground to absolve the accused from the charge of rape. It has to be established that there was consent by her for that particular occasion. In 2018, Supreme Court in State v. Pankaj Chaudhary 2018 held that even in cases where there is some material to show that the victim has habituated to sexual intercourse, No interference like the victim being a woman of loose moral character is permissible to be drawn from that circumstance alone. A woman of easy virtue also could not be raped by a person for that reason, it was observed. That's all for the topic. Thank you. Have a nice day.